Hello and welcome back, dear friends. It's me, Odo, and we are back in our campaign of EU4 with Sweden. Last time we just won a war against Poland, Lithuania. We took not too much, just 3 provinces, one for our vassal Pomerania, 2 for ourselves. We still need these 3 provinces for our achievement, but this will be done soon. But now we can take the last influence idea, Marcher Lords, which will give us more force limit. Also, we now have minus 50% unjustified demands. This is really great. Also, we can now take on this foreign policy. Weather cost minus 10%. Aggressive expansion minus 10%. That's also nice. Let's see, we could take military tech early, but I really don't think so. We don't need it. Yeah, we are in a war together with Austria against Castilian. Castile just attacked Utrecht because of their Flemish lands. I think they have a claim there from some events or something like that. And the problem is, I don't think that he saw that Austria will get his allies as well, because Austria is defending Utrecht because it's part of the Holy Roman Empire. And Castile saw that Austria will defend, but as the emperor is attacked himself in this, that he attacks one of the member states of the Holy Roman Empire, the emperor can summon his allies, and the allies of Austria are quite impressive, because I mean they have me as ally, Hungary, Brandenburg, the Palatinate, Saxony, and Memmingen. I mean, Memmingen is okay, but Brandenburg is huge. Saxony normally is also huge, but this time it's small. But Hungary is not. Hungary is small. Hungary is stupid Hungary. Yeah, and therefore this green blob here is at war with this red blob here. I don't intend to do anything in this war, because as you can see, we have no manpower at all. I will just try to regenerate from our devastating war with Poland. And then take some more troops after we retrain them. Still some. We need so many troops still. And the next war will be with Denmark to get more land here on the Danish islands and half island. This will be not as brutal as the war with Poland. Also, the next war with Poland will be probably easier to win. But I think Austria can handle this by themselves anyway. We are winning this war at the time, so I don't fear that Castilians will come to us. Truce with Mecklenburg is up. I'm not sure. Can we integrate you? Nah, we can't integrate you because we are at war. But we could integrate you, yes, after this war. We'll probably integrate you because you're just a one province minor and you don't have any interesting claims for us. Probably this one in Uckermark. Because we need this for one of our missions. Probably. We probably can't declare war on you, yeah, because you're together in a war. An impressive lot of Spanish troops. But there are some more Austrians hiding in. Yeah, we should do some more claim fabrication. Black news, no! Our king has died. Why? But why? Let's boost stability a bit. Is just would be nice if we would be at war at the time. Looks like Castile. Didn't calculate with the mighty armies of Sweden that are just standing around and doing nothing. Well, probably not nothing, but getting a new hairstyling and stuff. There are a lot of Spanish troops here. Muscovy is claiming some of our land. This is also a reason why we should just Just ignore this war. This will go away from it by itself, I think. There are a lot of troops from the Spanish Alliance. Oh, manpower is recovering. A lot of troops. A lot of troops. Come on, Utrecht, peace out. Nah. Castile is still high enthusiasm. They didn't lose too much. Is really interesting as they are destroying a lot of manpower there. Oh, this is nice. My new land is converted by the conversion centers. Yay! That's great. So I don't have to pay something for it. So Aachen peaced out. Danzig is now Protestant, yay! Still Memel left. Ah, wait, we have 200 church power, so we probably should get rid of this at the moment and do something other. We don't need the prestige, the legitimacy, the settlement, settler increase, manpower recovery speed. Yeah, that's the thing that we need at the time. Something. Ah, oh, I missed this. Utrecht is not occupied yet. Though it seemed for some time that they would occupy it. Interesting. Early. What could we do with military points instead? We could roll some generals. Would have 5 to 14 pips. But we have +1 fire, +2 shock, and +1 skill, siege skill. So does this mean it's 9 to 18? Let's see. Where is the new guy? Christian Gustafsson. Nah. Let's see, are there any good leaders there? Sigismund Rangel. This is the newest one. So wait a bit. We have here 5141. This is 11. 6311. This is 9, 10, 11. Nah. We don't like you. This one has 3 siege pips, but he's just 7, he's just 10. Yeah, go away. Let's do 2 more. Ah, 5, 6, 2, 3. This one is great. This one has 11, 13, 16 pips. Let's get rid of you. Stay with this guy. That's okay. Ah. I forgot to claim stuff. How about this war ending soon? Ah, they're already at medium enthusiasm. Good. Not get prestige for a bit of admin power and money. Or we lose prestige. Yeah, why not? So wait a bit. There are ships from Naples and Castile. Are there some transports with them? Yeah, we have some transports with them. Are you stupid? Let's move there. Let's move there. These are mainly transports. You don't have any leader. You go there. I really don't want them to. What are you doing there? So France has ended. Okay. You've got 1,000. Let's make a second army with 8,000 8,000 cannons. They seem not to do something. They're just there. I'll stop it. How about you protect trade in Lübeck? Let's see, how's trade going? Why are we not controlling the trade in Lübeck? Probably we should form Danzig. I should have done this before. Do they have a lot of claims? Yeah. Also here. This is all part of Danzig. We could use Danzig's claim for the Let's get to peace. Come on. I want to integrate Mecklenburg. Set you on scutage, so if we get into peace and I forget to annex you. Oh, come on. This was stupid. Religious turmoil in the whole of the German Empire. Protestants everywhere, Reformed everywhere. Nearly the whole of Italy is Protestant. Just Rome and some provinces here in Cantabria. Interesting. Wait, what? We have some revolt. Where is a revolt? Stolp. Danzigian separatists. Yeah. I mean, we really don't want to fight peasants. They're not interesting. Don't approve of separatists. Probably lost Utrecht. This can drag on for years now. Just for one small stupid province. Let's give it to them. The Roman Empire is lost anyway. You don't have any authority. The only thing that you can hope is that the Protestants will take over from you and lead the Holy Roman Empire to some glory. Yay, even more Protestants. 17 heretic princes. This is not heresy. I'm not sure if I should just declare war on you. I mean, I just would have to fight you and Oldenburg. Probably this would be not so bad at all. Let's lose some money. Nah. Stop. What did I do? Let's declare war on you. Why not take Holstein? With this leader, we'll go to Oldenburg and take care of this guy. Stop. Let's take military tech early. Why not? Let's take the Tertia, better in defense. Let's move here. Thank you. Hey. There was some peace with someone in this war. Not sure who peaced out. Ah, Savoyan. So the attackers are one attacker less. Quality, that's the way. Sweden gets better exports, trade efficiency plus 5%, and global trade power plus 5%, that's nice. And also production efficiency plus 10%. For Mecklenburg. Okay, this seems to be the end of the war. Yep. Treaty of Tordesillas. Okay. My queen consort regent Utrecht accepted peace. Utrecht will be forced to give Castile 10% of their income. This will last for 10 years, so they went. They were not conquered. So technically, we won. Okay, let's sue for peace. Let's give me everything you have, like money and prestige points. Got Sjöland. Oh, we destroyed his whole fleet. Nice. Oh, come on. Should be enough to kill him. Come on, take this fort. Hey, and we've got a new king. And he starts his reign by killing some Danes. Westland and Admin Tech 20. Yeah, well, this will take some time. Some more time. So, let's see. Let's take these and that. So we got everything that we need to form Scandinavia. Let's take this. Yeah, that's even more nice. will be some unrest in the German lands, but who cares? I think not that it really matters. Just give me more reparations as well. Oof. This costs a lot of points. This is really expensive. Oof. Good, we didn't take admin tech early. Pomerania wants some royal marriage, yeah, why not? Okay, there are some rebels somewhere there. Akershus. We need to build some fort down here. Okay, institution spread. How far with institutions? We've got the Renaissance, and that's it. So, next would be. colonialism. We've got colonialism. Next would be printing press in 1550. This is 7 years from now. How long until we get the next? We gain 7 splendor, so it takes us 800 divided by 7 is 100 and. And 115 months. This is nearly 10 years. So in 10 years we get the next splendor bonus. But the next institution will be in 7 years. I mean, these things are not really important. Yeah, let's take the institution spread. I mean, we could have taken the trade ships as well. Let's see. Let's build some fortress around here. Because we have fortresses here, a lot of fortresses here, we don't have that many there. Trendelag is good, but there are 1, 2, 3, 4, Rikers Hus. We should build a fort in Rikers Hus. After we've defeated this stupid rebels there, we will do this. Ah, we are at peace, so we could integrate you. Let's integrate you. How many? We could have another. So let's create Danzig. Danzig will have cores on all of this. That's good. Okay. We will make Poland Protestant. Also, France has some problems with these guys. Get through my country, Denmark. Let's build a fort here. Then kill some rebels. Ships go trade. So, okay, at this point, my dear friends, we will stop for today again. Oldenburg? Yeah, Oldenburg is still in Lübeck, so it was okay to take his trade power. Until we see each other again, I hope you enjoyed it, and see you next time. Bye!